Professor Raphael Mechoulam was the key speaker at the third edition of the UFCM iCare Symposium in Strasbourg. Mechoulam and his research group succeeded in isolating tetrahydrocannabinol, or THC, the psychoactive ingredient in cannabis, for the very first time exactly 50 years ago.
50 years is a long time, very long time. I was a young man then. I'm not so young anymore.
After 50 years, the acceptance of medicinal cannabis the world over remains a slow process.
So until there is a complete separation between the illegal use and the medical use, people will always think, nothing, he's taking it for the high. Physicians like to use well-specified drugs.
Evidence-based.
Not only evidence-based, but also specified completely. They want to know what a person is getting. If you go to a physician, if you have anything, you go to a physician, the physician will say, take 300 milligrams of an antibiotic two times a day, take it for a week, then come back to me. It doesn't go away. They want to have something which is completely defined. With cannabis, it is not.
So Mechoulam pleads for more clinical trials, because only then will cannabis be widely accepted as a cancer treatment in any form.
You see the possibility, but in order to do a large-scale study, you need funds. An academic person doesn't have the facilities to do something like that. A company has the facilities. It may cost a few million dollars. They can do it. I cannot. I mean, my funds are funny. I fight in order to get a grant of $50,000 in order to employ or to have a few students. That's it. So things are difficult in this respect for an academic person.
But the world seems to be awakening. More and more companies with increasing influence are becoming involved in research and development.
There is no patent, and if there is no patent, then why waste money? Waste, from their point of view. And I think that now there will be changes. There are going to be changes because companies see that there is a big market for cannabidiol and maybe mixtures and so on. Maybe they will take and make derivatives, like they have done with almost all drugs. They will take a drug and make a derivative, which is more active and which is probably better. And so we can have something of that going on.
Professor Mechoulam is not alone in his belief. Dr. Manuel Guzman, the Spanish researcher, has also called for more clinical trials.
We also need to prove clinically that cannabis is actually positive, is actually good for treating several diseases, because now sometimes the evidence is not so strong. So for the patients, it's nice to have a kind of shortcut and be able to use cannabis oil and other preparations from the plant, but it would be nice to conduct robust clinical trials to get to know whether cannabis can be useful in different diseases.
Guzman has received funding for a new study on brain tumors.
We hope that with these trials, plus others that have been conducted in other places in the world, we'll be able to get to know finally whether cannabinoids are useful anti-cancer drugs and neuroprotective drugs in different diseases.
To make real progress in the development and study of cannabinoids, the plant itself should be legalized.
The main problem, I think, is that cannabinoid compounds are supposed to be active components of illegal drugs, so that they are into the what we call the Schedule 1 drug. So it's very complicated and requires a lot of paper stuff to get the licenses for importing, with for exporting, for managing all these compounds. So not only for basic research, but also for clinical trials, it's pretty complicated to work with cannabinoids compared to other compounds that may be even more dangerous for the health, but they have not so many restrictions.
Connect with us on Facebook, Twitter, and YouTube.